it's over the course of 10 years. It's a decade of excellence for head coach Jeff Walls and the Louisville Cardinals.
Cards win the tip, and we are underway here at the Glass House. Darren Park, I'm Jake Rose. Thank you for joining us on this Sunday matinee here in Central Time. Women's basketball event. Carr in the lane, rattles home the first points. That's Chrislyn Carr.
I'm so looking forward to this matchup for two reasons. Number one, I'm excited to see how Middle Tennessee is going to defend Louisville. They're going to have a game plan. They're going to take away Louisville's strengths. They're going to play to a scouting report. That's what Rick Ensel does. Jeff Walls does the same thing at Louisville, but he's got a couple tricks up his sleeve. He's always got something, and you saw it there, a little full court pressure to start the game off.
Courtney Blakely making her second consecutive start, filling in for the injured Alexis Whittington. For Middle is tied up, two on the shot clock for the Lady Raiders on their opening possession. That ball is tapped away, and it's going to be a shot clock violation as Senior Malashka, second leading scorer for Middle Tennessee, coming in off the bench. And that's going to be a travel. Hailey Van Lith.
Well, that was a good call by the officials. And again, you'll see Louisville here extending that full court pressure. They would love to speed up Middle Tennessee. That's going to be the plan early here for Jeff Walls. He wants to try to speed up Middle's offense, take them out of a rhythm, because then when they're in a good rhythm, they're very, very good executing in the half court.
Malashka, step back jumper.
She's got range to the three-point line, so that's a tough match for Cochran down low.
Morgan Jones misses everything. And that's going to be a foul going against Louisville of Malashka.
And you can see Louisville now into a 2-3 zone.
As Wheeler puts up the three. She's been trying to find her stroke the last couple of weeks. Carr in transition. Gives it up to Van Lith. And Cochran goes right through her defender for an easy two.
Great job of Cochran getting low position right there. And she was able to just turn and score over Malashka. It was all about getting her work done early and getting that low post position.
Now Malashka to the corner three.
And that's what I said. That's the matchup. That's a tough guard for Cochran to extend all the way out to the perimeter right there.
Conference USA's sixth player of the year last season.
And you can see she's not comfortable. Cochran's not comfortable having to go all the way out to the perimeter right there to contest that shot. Nice extra pass by Savannah Wheeler.
Kind of goes without saying, but Middle Tennessee is going to have to knock down some jumpers as Jalen Gregory connects back-to-back threes for Middle Tennessee.
That time Louisville went 3-2 zone to try to cover the perimeter, but they were just a little late rotating over, and Jalen Gregory, that's a good sign for Middle for her to hit her first three.
Middle on top by four. They go right back to Cochran in the paint, and one.
We talk about, as a post player, you can get post touches or paint touches. She's getting paint cut touches right now. When she gets those paint touches, she's buried Malashka. That's an easy score for her at the rim.
And she misses the free throw. And Blakely.
Real strategic coaching move to start those two point guards, especially against a team like Louisville that's going to get out and pressure you 94 feet.
Whitson will line up a three and knock it down. Middle has connected on three straight from distance. Carr quickly going the other way. Now Russell will put up the three in and out. And Cochran with the offensive rebound and fighting through the contact.
One of those rare scorers that can create a shot for herself. She can do it a multitude of different ways. Middle Tennessee will come at her with all sorts of different options to try to slow her down.
Middle goes around the horn. Whitson off the mark from the wing. And Van Lith clears.
That's a shot Coach Ensel wants Courtney Whitson to take. She's very capable of making that.
Middle has missed their last five, but Louisville after that shot.
Louisville back to man-to-man defense right there.
Not enough on the pass from Whitson, looking for Wheeler as that three in transition will roll home.
You can see there Gregory doing a nice job sandwiching Cochran. That scouting report defense, that's what we talked about. Middle Tennessee, their coaches have done an amazing job scouting Louisville and preparing their team to play. They're going to take away Louisville's strengths tonight.
Middle has not scored a bucket in over 5 minutes. Wheeler changes that for their first point. 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Carr, hesitation, runner, no. Cochran, offensive rebound, count it.
Crashing the offensive boards. Four offensive rebounds for Louisville early on in this game. That's the reason they've got this early lead. And just throw up this little lob right here to Malashka.
So Liz Dixon, 6'5", comes in. Malashka off the window. Russell lines up the three. That one is short. Cochran got a hand on it. Crowd wants an over-the-back call, not getting it. Now Wheeler, one-on-one against Russell. Hard foul. Middle Tennessee's leading scorer, the transfer from Marshall. Knocks down the first, trying to find her stroke the last couple of games.
And she's averaging 17 points a game, and we're saying still trying to find her stroke. So just says what kind of player she is and how good she's going to be for Middle Tennessee.
Shot 37% for the Orange last year, led the team. As Wheeler tries and finishes with the left hand against Mikasa Robinson, second team foul, her first, as Gregory is off the front of the rim for the three. Van Lith able to finish with a right hand. Marika Kono from Sendai, Japan. One of three international players on Jeff Walls' squad. Middle with some international flavor as well. Four players from other countries. As there's 10 on the shot clock. Malashka got Cochran on her heels, goes to the lane, and finishes smooth with the left hand.
But that time, as Malashka turned to face, she definitely reached in around her. That was a good call.
So Middle gets a fresh 20.
Great Gregory. Extra pass.
In the corner, knocks down the three.
There first. I've seen that called a charge an awful lot.
Van Lith misses the jumper. Just 4 points tonight so far. The leading score for Louisville as Malashka.
In 18 seasons since they've gotten their head jobs in 2005 and 2006. Coach Ensel worked it on the last call. Woodson's been on the floor with two fouls and has done a really nice job of her middle game. Is very, very nice.
Malashka, tough drive in and out. But Whitson there with the offensive board, and she's able to clean it up.
with these two teams playing, you're right. This is a high-level matchup between two very, very good basketball teams, and we're going to talk about it as this game progresses, but I can't say enough. Jeff Wallace bringing his number 18 Louisville team on the road. He's played a real difficult schedule. I know we want to talk about that at some point, but it's just a credit to him that he's willing to play this game in this type of an environment.
Whitson puts up the three and buries it. They go to Williams in the post over Boldareva. No, Boldareva fighting for it. And Middle able to clear.
Coach Ensel wants him to run.
Boldareva steps into a three. Who starts this third quarter on the bench. Whitson again for three. Got it this time.
As a shot blocker, those are always the most fun.
Well, they never see you coming. We know from our experiences, elite shot blockers.
Getting blocked.
Malashka, she has 14 points as Middle has their biggest lead tonight at 15.
Now Cochran just, it's really a tough guard for her to guard Malashka on the three-point line. That was a big three and a big answer for Louisville right there.
Russell knocks him down at a 46% clip. They shot 15 of them so far. Lead is 12 for Middle as Malashka going to work against Cochran. Uses the wing a little bit and draws the foul. Part of the 2019 Atlantic 10 all-rookie team. Hits the second, now with 15. Russell, another three. She misses. Carr with the offensive board and puts it up and in.
But what a great spirited crowd here today. And Lady Raiders are really feeding off their energy. And they've been into it ever since the second quarter, Jake.
Cochran, tough drive. 1 point away from her season high of 13, which she set against Belmont as the three finally goes. But it's just one of eight from the floor. And it's still a 14-point advantage for Middle Tennessee. Whitson, another three. Money!
Too low where those little guards could get their hands on it. You teach your bigs, keep the ball high, explode right back up with it. Everything going right now for the Lady Raiders.
Just 7 points so far here in the third quarter. Louisville had seven the entire second quarter. So Middle Tennessee getting it done on both ends of the floor. As Wheeler has 10 on the shot clock. Checked by Hailey Van Lith. Now five. Wheeler drives.
Because this is another good test for his team, but he was very respectful and very worried about bringing his team down here to Murfreesboro because he knew what Middle Tennessee is capable of.
Freshman from Wichita, Kansas. Wichita Heights High School. Four-star prospect. Getting her first action tonight in a Cardinal uniform. Less than 20. Boldareva going to work now. Wheeler wide open for three. Count.
Inside out at its best right there. Boldareva drew the double team, and she absolutely made the correct pass out to Savannah Wheeler.
Two on the clock. Walker's got to do something with it. Tough shot. Count it. Cochran charging hard to the lane. Count it.
On the number 18 team in the country. Great slip by Malaska there.
Wheeler, corner three, and she's fouled.
They'll try to contest that without fouling.
Foul is on the freshman. Was the Kentucky Miss Basketball Award winner back in 2019 at Boyd County High School. And she hits all three free ones. Harris on the drive. Nice find by Carr. So Nyla Harris, the freshman from Orlando, Florida. She misses both free throws. Going to get another shot at it here. Gets Walker off her feet. Jumper can't go, and now cleared by Van Lith. Walker tried to drop it off. Van Lith wide open three. Got it. And just like we talked about during the break, Louisville showing some full court pressure. And Middle beats it pretty easily. Wheeler to the rack, and a foul going against Cochran.
Worst case scenario, they get two free throws.
And that is the fourth foul. Van Lith pull up three. Cochran staying with it. Lost it and gets it back. And that is a foul.
Both teams with four team fouls. So any fouls the rest of the way is going to be two free throws for either team. Five offensive rebounds tonight.
This is the second. Louisville, Blakely. Tough drive, misses it. Here comes Morgan Jones. Harris drains it.
And gave Jones that easy 15-foot jumper.
Middle trying to use as much clock as they can on every possession. Up by 13, 4.5 to go.
You want to use clock, but you still want to get a quality shot within your offense.
Now five on the shot clock again. Wheeler in trouble. Has got to put up a tough one. Got it!
It's without a doubt Middle Tennessee's best defensive performance to date this season.
As Whitson hits the first.
He said, we're ready to play. He said, we practiced for about an hour. Usually go for a little over two. Coach Ensign blew the whistle, brought him in, said, we're ready, let's go. No need to keep going at this. So, again, he had a finger on this team. He understood they were ready to play, and they've come out, and they've absolutely played defensively. She's a competitor.
Scoreless tonight, averages 10.5 points as Wheeler is free on the release, and she is fouled.
So she's going to the foul line for two shots.
For the junior from Columbus, Georgia. As Wheeler knocks down another free throw. ...28% from the floor tonight is Louisville. As their shooting woes continue, they really struggled in the second half loss against Ohio State at home during the ACC Big Ten Challenge. As Blakely, tough drive.
Fourth, fifth in the country. I mean, that's a perennial NCAA tournament team. This just shows Middle Tennessee turned back to his staff.
Morgan Jones, the transfer from Florida State, for in the transfer portal this offseason. Gets both free throws. Less than a minute as Van Lith put on the line. Her tough shooting night continues.
Great win for the Lady Raiders. The crowd really appreciative of the effort today by this young team.
As high hopes for the NCAA tournament this year. They're getting ready to knock off a Final Four team from last year.
And they've earned it. They've earned this win today. They understood what was at stake and the importance of what this win could do for them moving forward for the season.
And we're going to have a whistle on Blakely. So if you're Jeff Walls, as you said, he knew that he had a different team coming into this night. And they've played a really, really tough schedule. Doesn't get a whole lot easier as they have to go to Kentucky, at Pitt, and DePaul. Before the end of the month, where do you go from here?
You stay the course. This win or this loss doesn't define you. There's a reason they're picked number one in the ACC. They've got a tough conference schedule ahead. But tonight's about Middle Tennessee, and this is their opportunity to celebrate a great win.
This building has been around for a long, long time, and Rick Insull has won a lot of ball games inside the glass house. But none of them been as sweet as this.